We wish you a Merry Diwali, Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, Christmas.
And a Happy New Year and Chinese New Year.
Hey, oh no, your glasses are gone. Oh, I feel so much less raged.
Welcome to GDPG, everybody.
Hey, everyone.
So, in light of the holidays, we decided to play the most festive game we could
muster up, really. Yeah, I mean.
And that's clearly the South Park N64 game. So.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be great.
Oh, yes. So, let's jump in. Tony, you're going to be the one playing this one.
Oh, all right. And Chris, for the holidays, even got us set up with a green controller.
And a red controller.
Oh,
there's the chance,
man,
though, that all of these green things are going to conflict with our new
green screen. So we'll find out. If my head disappears during the beginning, it's because I'm a ghost.
Pretty much, yeah.
Ghost. Okay, so should we just get started?
Yeah, let's do this.
All right.
So have you ever played this game before?
No.
Great.
It's going to be so good. Are we going to story mode?
Yeah, let's do story mode.
Let's just do it.
Maybe we could do multiplayer if we want to do like a bonus thing.
Oh, yeah. Start a new game? Yep. Let's just start a new game.
So we're not playing through the whole episode. We can just pass
it. I don't have a rumble pack.
So we're not going to play through the whole game.
Okay, here's the problem. Who do we play? Who should I play as?
Well, see, we unlocked some extra characters. See if... Can you, like, scroll to all the way to the right?
Nope.
Oh, okay, so that
it's
is only for multiplayer.
Yeah, it's just for multiplayer. I feel like Cartman is the embodiment of the Christmas spirit.
There you go.
So, Cartman it is.
Perfect. Oh, I'm so happy we're doing this.
In case you guys are wondering why we sung that wonderful rendition of We Wish You a Merry Christmas / everything else, if you're not caught up with South Park this season, the PC police are a thing, and the PC principal. So, we're all about being that PC life, bro.
Hello, children. Did you hear the news?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, these graphics, though.
Oh, man, remember the days when Chef was a character?
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah, and then they did that RoboChef thing for, like, a season or an episode.
Didn't the voice actor that plays Chef leave because they had that Scientology episode?
Mm-hmm. Yep, I think he was a Scientologist, and he didn't like the way they're being portrayed. Oh, man, I'm throwing snowballs.
Yep.
Okay, I figured it out, guys. I am a genius. I don't know what I'm throwing it at. It's the Z button. Or the trigger.
And then the joystick is what changes the angle. How do you move forward? Is it like the...
I haven't tried. Yeah, that's super weird.
Is that... Don't let it get you, man.
I can't even see where I'm at. Where the hell are you, you turkey bastard?
I think you have unlimited ammo with this regular snowballs.
I know, but where the hell are the turkeys?
I don't know. So I think the goal is that we have to kill all the turkeys. Maybe we just have to get somewhere.
Well, I can't kill any turkey. Oh my god! Oh, turkey attack! Oh, turkey attack! Yeah, murder the turkeys! All the dead turkeys!
Wow, you did surprisingly well.
I don't know why I'm alive.
You only took 22 points of
damage. Oh god, I hear the gobbles.
Get him, man, get him.
Oh god, these controllers are super sensitive. So if I take some damage, this might be the only way I win. Hold on. There you go. Oh yeah. Fuck you, turkey.
Would you ever have expected a South Park game on the N64 to be a first person shooter?
Wait, there's still someone else? Where is it last year?
There it is. So you can see on the little like mini map.
Yeah, but like for some.
Oh. What is the blue thing?
I think that's
turn right. No. Turn right. Oh yeah, you need to get to your friends. It's about time you made it. Bikini meat. Oh, I wonder if getting them gives you more lives.
I don't know, but I'm about to die because I suck.
Dude, you gotta.
I am not a first-person shooter player.
So if you don't know the story of this game, apparently an alien force has come to this planet in the form of turkeys, and so that's why we.
And they're ruining Christmas.
And something like that, at least. We're gonna believe that that's the case.
Oh god. Oh, this is so sensitive. Oh, this is why you shouldn't play video games, ladies and gentlemen. In case you're wondering, I am a professional video game player. You can find me at imnotreallyaprofessionalplayer.com, we'll have that displayed right over the TV screen.
Yeah, and all sponsors welcome.
Yeah, yeah. Looking for sponsorships from Lego and MLG.
Ooh, okay, maybe this is where you gotta go.
Ooh, the Renaissance Fair.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, no. No, no, no.
Those
no,
are,
no.
Those are people.
Those
man.
Bastard turkeys. Turkey time! Oh, no! Oh, God. Oh, it's just maybe, blood everywhere. Maybe, my maybe, blood maybe. Is... Oh, my God. I'm stuck. I am stuck. I am bad at this,
got,
ladies
and gentlemen.
You got
7 health left, man.
I got 5 health. 5 is my lucky number. I'm down to 1. I died.
Ooh.
Can I still throw my... Oh. Oh, game over.
440. Good job, buddy.
Yay!
Should we swap every time we die?
Yeah, because I suck. So I'm going to be G-Ma. That's going to be my name.
In your defense, Tony, I feel like anybody playing any N64 first-person shooter is going to suck because they were not... With one joystick, how do you even...
G-Ma Fatty Cakes. That's what I'm going to be called. No, I'm just G-Ma. Screw that. That takes too long. All right. G-Ma. Because everyone should love their G-Ma.
Yeah. Way to have the holiday spirit. Hey, you're the top of the high scores.
Oh, yeah, I'm the high scorer. I'm the high scorer.
Oh, okay, we can continue. All right, now I got to figure out these controls. Get out of here, chef. No one cares. All right.
I better keep my eyes open for the other game.
I better keep my eye open. See, you're better at this already. So, I was just spinning in circles.
I think the key really is to use the left and the right to shimmy. Because... Using the joystick is like...
Dude, it's danger. That's what I was doing. Like, if you use the... Oh, I thought I heard the gobbles of doom.
Oh, it's Kenny.
Oh, I missed Kenny. Oh, he's poor. I'm just kidding, guys. I'm poor, too.
Well, you know, everyone knows that in the holidays you're supposed to neglect the poor people, right?
Yeah, right. That's at least I'm sure that's Cartman's version of how the holidays work.
Yeah, we're just embodying the spirit of Cartman.
Yeah, really, Cartman is Christmas, if you think about it.
Ooh, buffet.
Ooh, KJ's buffet.
All right, ain't no turkey's gonna stand up to this. Mm.
That's not fair. You just know how to play a game better than I do. I call bullshit.
So I've noticed this is becoming a trend in a lot of our playthroughs where, like, I'll have Cujo start playing a game and, like, he'll do awful. So I'll be like, how about you let me take a spin at it, Cujo?
Oh, hold on there, Mr. Affinity Chris. Are you telling me that I'm doing just as poorly as Cujo?
I mean, we all saw your playthrough of Down.
Okay, all right. Come on, fine. You know what? I'm here for color commentary.
God damn it, Kay.
God damn it, Kay. Eh.
Whoa, man, Cartman, you can throw these snowballs like a boss.
Well, think about it. Cartman is a bully.
Did I get everybody?
Dude, you got everybody. I missed Kenny. How did I miss Kenny?
To be fair, that's
worse than killing Kenny.
In a way, yeah. Because like, then there's no longer an opportunity to kill him.
Dude, play some football, man. You got this.
Ain't got no time.
See, now you're trying to hurt them too.
Well, you
beat my high score already, so you can die now.
Alright. Great.
will you stop doing that much better than me? At least make it look like I'm not the worst player on earth.
I mean, you know, I do what I can to.
Oh, you look at that roast. I'm surprised that doesn't stop Cartman. There should be like a, I want that roast.
Dude, the best thing about going to the Renaissance Fair is the giant turkey legs.
You know, I went to the Renaissance Fair for the first time last summer. I've never been to one before. I know, right? My girlfriend. Yeah, I know, right? And the turkey leg was amazing, but we went back this summer. And I just was not feeling the turkey. Like, I remember how full I felt afterwards.
Damn.
And we still did a whole bunch of walking. And having a turkey gut's not good. Already having the, like, beer keg for a belly is not so good for me.
Oh, this is an inverted joystick. Yeah, screw that rabbit. Oh, God.
Oh, turkeys! So I guess there is a movie. I think it's Attack of the Killer Turkeys or... Oh, no, it's Thanksgiving.
What? This is a legitimate movie?
So I think what we should do right now, Chris, is we should show the poster for Thanksgiving.
Okay.
It's a wonderful killing turkey, and I think we should have a GDPG movie night at some point and watch Thanksgiving, because I hear it's wonderful.
I don't know. I mean, copyright-wise, we probably can't put that on the show, but maybe
we can just reaction it, maybe, or just have, like, a night where we all just, you know, pick up a bottle of Malort's.
And every time the movie gets bad,
we just take a shot of Malort and see where the night takes us.
I mean, that would certainly make for an interesting night.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this point, this is the show-off phase that Chris is doing, where he's like, let me not just only beat Tony's score, let me embarrass him in the process. That's right, in the process.
I mean, everyone knows that the person that owns the game is always the best player, right?
You know, I own plenty of games I suck at, Chris. I own plenty of sucky games that I suck at.
To tell you what, Tony, after we do this playthrough of this single episode, we should do another short episode of us doing the arena matches in the multiplayer.
Yeah, we should. That's how I'll find the real winner.
You can redeem yourself there.
Oh, boy. Let's call it redemption. I have a feeling it's going to be more like fall on my facedom, but that's okay.
Nah, Tony.
Dude, I'm going to, like, have nightmares about gobbles now.
You know, that's fair. I think I already did, and then I played this game, and I was like... Maybe it was all like repressed memories from when I played this when I was like 12.
Did you recently rebuy this game, or has this just been in your collection the whole time?
I've just had this game in my collection the whole time.
Wow.
And we were racking our brains to like think of some holiday games to play on the show. And I was like, well, I know I have to at least have some. And I found we wanted... So basically what we're doing, I don't know where this is going to release in the series, but we're doing one episode of a holiday game for every day of... The Christmas week. We found four games, and I was like, okay, perfect, now we just need one more. And I was like, oh, shit, what else do we have? And it was like a week later where I was like, oh my god, I have a South Park game that's holiday-ish.
Dude, it's all about that holiday South Park.
The nice thing is, we could have even played this for, like, Thanksgiving, you know?
Yeah, right? It kind of has a Thanksgiving vibe because you're killing turkeys with snowballs.
Alien turkeys, no less.
Right. But I feel like with all this snow, it reminds more of Christmas than Thanksgiving.
Right. I feel like most of our Thanksgivings generally don't have snow.
Right, and that's in most places.
Right.
And like really, Thanksgiving's not when winter's happening. Winter hasn't even technically started yet, right?
That's true, yeah.
So when you look at it, I have a feeling that the alien turkeys are trying to finally win back the holiday season.
Oh, there you go.
Because Christmas has been edging farther and farther. Soon, we'll get done with the 4th of July, and we're going to start... Oh, dude, come on. Don't beat up the bear. I hope he eats you.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
See, this is what happens when you eat a bear.
Oh, God. A struck
dude,
from behind.
Will you just, like, not... Will you stop being so good? Here, give me the controller.
Wait. There's... Oh, yes.
Is that the last turkey? Wait, are those pea snowballs?
Yes, they are.
Oh, how did you do that?
You can change your weapon with the D-pad.
Oh, my sweet lord. We should have had a test run before we started playing this.
Well, I remember this was a thing. The struggle with the pea snowballs is that they deal more damage, but they're slower.
Yeah, you can tell they're a little slower.
Because you gotta unzip your pants.
You gotta unzip your pants. And, like, I wonder if Cartman has a bladder problem. If he can just like kind of pee on command, he may want to go see a doctor.
I mean, he's a big kid, right?
Yeah,
like, he can probably hold a lot of water in his body. I mean, it's basically giant human sponge.
But peeing that much is not healthy for your kidneys are in overdrive.
Cheesy poofs everywhere, man.
Dude, cheesy poofs
Wait, what
everywhere.
Is this?
That looks like a golden ram.
Oh, it is. I thought it was pink. I'm also colorblind, so...
Colorblind, Chris.
Was it gray?
No, it was a gray... It was like a white goat with, like... golden horns.
Oh, okay.
Yellow horns.
Well, everything's gonna taste my snowball death.
Okay, so now you have done, like, so much better than I have. Like, 1,000% better than I have.
I mean, it's a game design show, right? So we gotta show the people the glory of this game. Oh my God,
right, you gotta show how much better you are than me. I get it. No, I get it. I get it.
It's all in the holiday spirit, too.
Yeah, fuck that. There ain't no holiday spirit when you're killing my score. Can't you at least be a little bad? Like, come on.
I'm doing terribly, Tony.
Oh,
I don't understand.
I'm abysmal.
Look at all that damage that I've taken. It's shameful.
Oh, it's just shameful. Yep. I had that in like the first... Ooh, cheesy poo. Oh, you got shitting me.
Oh, it's health.
Oh, why couldn't that be their dodgeball?
Yeah, buddy.
Ooh, this is gonna be good.
Oh, nice.
So now it looks like there's no level structure. It looks like you just kind of keep going.
Yeah, I actually don't... Oh, the dodgeball just, like, goes through them. Oh, God.
Can the dodgeball hit you back?
Man. And you can do a power throw.
Oh, jeez. Wait, did you just hold down the trigger? Oh, you must be out. No, I pressed the down on the D-pad.
Hit A? Oh, A changes your weapon.
That's okay. Weird.
Oh god, oh god, oh god.
So are you actually like moving the camera now or?
Yes.
Okay. That was my problem. That camera, isn't that joystick super sensitive?
It's very sensitive.
I'm not crazy. I think I just made the mistake of like relying on the joystick.
This one turkey is like, there can only be one!
I am the master turkey, gobble gobble goo. Dude, you killed Bambi!
Yeah, fuck Bambi.
Oh, here's the finish. I see a finish line, so it's kind of like a race.
Oh, maybe there are levels then. This game is so crazy too, like, I gotta wonder what the development of this game was like. Were they, okay, yeah, there are levels. But were they just like, alright, We're gonna hire this game studio to make a game.
Yeah, right.
To, like, make a first-person shooter. Yeah. To, like, do stuff. It's like, the levels feel so open. It's actually, that is kind of, that's cool.
That's super cool. So now you can use Mr. Hanky.
Yeah. Nice. I don't know if, I think that's still only for multiplayer, though.
Oh, can you only save if you have a controller pack?
Oh, alright.
You can only save if you have a controller pack?
I guess so.
That's weird.
Maybe the game just,
I'm
like,
gonna start
okay,
this one
Okay, yeah,
out.
Yeah. This one's all you, buddy.
Watch me die in the first 5 seconds of this game. I made a farty noise. Hold on.
Wait. Are you getting damaged already?
No.
What's flickering
I
underneath
don't...
you? Wait. Look. Down. Touch that.
I don't know, man. Like.
I
hold on.
It's gotta be something. Maybe that's just like. This is where you started.
Yeah, I guess so. Maybe it's like a checkpoint.
But your compass is like, this is your objective, because it's like pointing at it. That's weird. That's really confusing.
Okay, well, I don't want to be in snow pea mode, because that's just going to go slower. Okay, so all I need to worry about is my left and my right. I can do this. No, get out of snow pea mode. Oh my god.
Do you still have the dodgeballs? Hit A.
Hit A? Yeah.
No? Oh yeah, you do.
Let's
okay,
give
nice.
A shot. Let's give it. Let's get,
you only have 13.
Okay, so I'm going to throw all 12 right now.
Perfect. Oh.
Oh.
A cutscene. Whoa.
This game is intense.
Oh, my.
The common is doing crazy, spooky things. We're being invaded by mutant turkeys.
I know, children. I saw it in the news.
Okay.
Do I have to censor this?
I think we should call the episode of this video Kids Allowed.
You know, I bet you anything that more kids, like, proper, like, young kids have seen more South Park than I have.
Oh, I'm sure. Oh, I'm sure.
Point. And it's funny, too, because, like, I like South Park a lot, but...
It's a lot of fun. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. Here come the gibble gobbles.
All right, you got this, man. You got this. If you mess up this high score, though, I will forever be disappointed.
Good. Good. You forever be disappointed.
Wait, what's over there?
I'm going to save my balls.
Yeah. Save your balls. You can put them in some turkey faces later.
That's literally just a flower.
All right, then. So, what do you think about this game? Actually, talking a little bit of game design, because we haven't done much yet. What do you think about this game and its lack of a crosshair?
I don't like it.
Yeah? Do you think it makes it too hard?
Well, here's my problem. I am not good at just doing this left-right mechanic, clearly.
Well, it's just... I mean, it's just difficult with N64, because...
Yeah, but you made it look like, I'm the master of everything. Okay, am I following... Like, am I supposed to follow the compass, or is it just telling me that north is down? Oh,
yeah,
my sweet mother of God.
Don't follow the compass. For whatever reason...
Dude, there's a reckoning on hand here. Hold
just,
on.
Just, like, spam it, dude. You got unlimited snowballs. Bring the pain. Although it looks like only two of them actually crossed the threshold.
That's fine. Fuck the rest of those goddamn chicken turkey mutants.
Oh, okay. Here's a fun fact about games that I don't know if we've ever mentioned in the show.
Can you make
before.
Like a fun fact title? Fun fact.
No. Oh. Maybe.
Never do anything. Fun.
Yeah, pretty much. I tried fun facts, like legitimate fun facts in our Lovers in a Dangerous Space-Time episode.
Yeah, that worked.
I don't think anyone really cared for them.
Oh, well,
so I was like, I don't know. Maybe I'll do it more often. I thought they were fun. But maybe.
I mean, because they're fun. Like, they're in the title. Like, you're expected
right?
to have a
exactly.
good time. So anyway, tell us what's awesome
okay,
about
so,
fun games.
Okay, so fun fact for game dev stuff. Do you see that fog in the distance?
Yes, I do see that fog.
The point of that fog is actually to limit the drawing distance so that the game console doesn't have to have as much in their memory load. So literally, when the fog covers an object, it's the game engine just like stops rendering it completely.
Oh, interesting.
So it doesn't tax the memory.
You know, also it's interesting, they have arrows pointing you where to go. So I wonder if people have literally just traversed around and got lost.
Probably.
Because there are specific arrows. Like, it's like...
And the arrow in the compass seems to point back to your starting
point. Oh, what is that? Oh, no.
I think you need a kickball.
Oh, no. Now I got this, motherfucker. I'm the best guy there.
It's literally pooping alien turkeys. It's literally pooping alien turkeys. Actually, you're doing pretty good.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
Except
this...
for that.
That was my...
Oh, God. Oh, God. Just keep backing up, man.
I think I got it.
It's behind you. It's behind you. It's literally behind you.
Why is it behind me? Is it stupid?
It just passed you up, I guess. Was it... I mean, it charged A. Oh, it's just not on the radar anymore.
Did it die?
Maybe? I feel like this is one of those things that you're supposed to kill.
Did it... Is it dead?
Let's just move forward.
I think I beat it, guys. I beat a boss. I'm redeeming myself.
You are redeeming yourself.
I'm doing better this round.
It's one of those things that just, like, you gotta warm up to it, man. Shit, he's gonna break the town. We gotta protect the town.
Oh, Jesus. How was I supposed to know that?
I bet you Chef was trying to tell us that.
We weren't listening to Chef.
Yeah.
I feel like there's a bunch of bad things I could say right now, but I won't.
What do you mean?
Nothing. I'm just not gonna talk.
Oh, okay then.
I shouldn't talk. Okay, so...
So, if, back in the day when N64 games were being released, how much were they selling these games for, like...
But dude, I don't remember, because $40? I never bought games when I was a kid. Like,
really?
My parents would buy games every so often. I never had, like, a big allowance or anything to blow on a game.
Well, there are more kickballs over there.
I mean, I'll grab more kickballs, but I don't know what's happening.
I have no idea either.
Chris, did I do something dumb here?
All right, well, maybe the...
So maybe we should cut for a minute until we find where we're supposed to go?
Yeah, we can cut.
Yeah. I love to pee out my snowballs.
Don't we all?
I can run and pee, run and pee, run and pee. Oh, I'm the best damn pee that you... Oh, there it is! No! That big old motherfucking turkey! Oh, it gained health back. Oh, good lord.
That's probably why it gave us that warning, is it went to the town to, like, go eat people and recover. That's my guess. I could be wrong. I could be very wrong. Oh, wow, that kickball dealt a lot of damage.
Oh, I'm too close. I am too close. Where are you, Turkey Tom?
Mayday.
Turkey Tom! Turkey Tom! Look out, look out!
That hill is messing... Oh, no.
No, I am bouncing it off that hill. I got the skills that kills! Oh, that turkey's gonna kill me, though. That turkey's actually
Oh, nice. Well, at least the last one was No, follow. Get it. You're so close.
Where'd it go?
Just spam that shit, man.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking...
I'm looking at turkey butthole.
Man, he's got a really gay... Oh, you got him! That gaping butthole is no more.
Dude, I ended that gaping butthole with some cheesy puffs. I did pretty well.
You did very well.
Look at that. I have not sullied your score.
Tony, I am proud. I'm confident to say that I once again believe in you as a player of games.
Guys, I need a moment. I didn't think this day would ever come. I don't know where the fuck I'm going. Like, should we go back to Chef's Love Shack?
Maybe go back to the...
Yo, be like, what's up? Nope.
Go back to the South Park sign? Maybe.
So here's my issue. So now we beat the turkey, right? I feel like there should have been some kind of, like, okay, can't like walk in between that.
Like, objective, like...
Yeah, you know, this game could have... But I'll grab more ammo, I guess. Oh, maybe I'm just re-picking up the balls that I dropped earlier?
I don't know. I mean, you got 10 from that. Go up to that sign, maybe? No? Okay, I think we just have to go past the turkey. It seemed like it's a very, constantly forward...
Yeah.
Kind of level
so
structure.
Things I like about this game, I think it's a lot of fun. I think it's simple spamming right now. I doubt it's going to change all that much. Where the fuck am I going?
There you go. I think that's the right way.
That's the right way. I may have gotten better at ball throwing, but my navigation sense is still way off.
Well, that's the thing, right? This game, it's weird because it's so open, but yet it still expects the player to go down this linear path. And I think it's open so that they can swarm you with a shitload of turkeys.
Right, exactly, which I think is a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. I think that's a good way to... Oh, wait, that's not new.
But at the same time, the short draw distance from the fog... Okay. It kind of also... Oh, that's where you gotta go. Oh, that's because the door had the giant turkey on it, so as soon as you killed it, it opened.
Well, there's another turkey, like, symbol, so maybe there's, like, you can go back to areas later?
Maybe.
possible. Oh, who's all full up on that?
Who's all
full up on that? But we're not going to use that right now. But we're going to listen to soothing sounds of peeing on a snowball. I'm just a peeing on a snowball. Peeing on a snowball. Yes, the song changed from last time because I don't have any rhythm sense. Peeing on a snowball.
Peeing on a snowball.
Yeah, pee. Oh, God. Oh, motherfucking turkeys. Motherfucking turkeys. Oh, God.
I've noticed that you tend to aim up.
I do tend to aim up.
Oh, here's a question for you.
Yeah, man.
How do you feel about inverted thumbsticks?
I am very bad at them. I think that I should be better at, though, because I feel like games should be inverted because the idea is you're looking like a person would look. And, like, for flight controls. I think for flight controls, inverted makes sense.
Right.
I'm bad at them. But I see why people play it. Like, my cousin is a very good gamer. Like, he was close to going onto the major league gaming circuit.
Turn around. Oh, no, never mind.
Turn around. Every now and then I feel a little bit. Oh, no, there's another giant turkey.
Dot. Yeah, man.
I'm not ready for
that. I think you gotta turn around.
No, I'm pretty sure it's this way.
Oh, shit. No, okay, never mind.
Turn around, bride. Oh, God. Fuck you, gobbly motherfuckers.
Oh, dude.
Okay, come on. That's horse shit. That is horse shit. You know what?
Oh, God.
Okay, so kickball time.
You need like a melee button.
Yeah, dude, I would be so much better at this game if there was a melee button.
I feel like that would almost be too violent though for this. Although I'm sure this game is already rated. Actually, I'm curious.
Oh, dude, you check that out while I'm trying to find the box of Cheesy Puffs, but I can't see crap.
You gotta kill him first, man.
No, there was another box of Cheesy Puffs.
Oh, was there? Oh, no, you got this. You got this. Dude, you've leveled up so much since the beginning of this game.
Yeah, motherfucker. Oh, fuck you, Turkey Tom. I'm gonna put you on my Jimmy John sandwich. Oh.
You want that
my
alien
God.
Turkey meat in you?
Dude, alien anything in me, please. What?
Especially
I'm sorry,
that gaping
guys.
Butthole.
Yeah, look at that gape. Oh, what? Oh, come on.
No, it's behind you. It's behind you. You just gotta turn around. Get it.
Do I turn around Bright Eyes?
Bright Eyes?
Every now and then I turn around. And I need whatever. And I just need your hold. I'm not even singing the lyrics right.
I think this is our best holiday episode yet.
Oh, dude. You're with me. That's why. I bring the funk and the holiday mojo.
Man, there's so much mojo right now, dude.
Oh, God. Turkeys all up in my balls.
I mean, the turkeys are feeling your mojo.
Yeah,
sure.
What the fuck? Okay,
you.
What's happening? Okay, I'm going to turn around.
I think whenever you're getting attacked, the key is to just, like, keep moving.
Yeah, right?
And then,
that's
like,
how...
turn
and,
around.
And then just
then...
turn right,
yeah. I mean,
yeah.
You can walk backward.
True.
I think that's usually what does it for me, because,
yeah.
Like, when they're close to you, it's so hard to aim, right?
Yeah, that's so my problem. I, like, tense up when we get to that big moment. I'm like, oh, God! Oh, no! See, that's why I'd be bad at horror games, because I get tense... And then the mutant zombie baby demons would eat my soul.
That's fair.
I assume all horror games have mutant zombie baby demons.
It's pretty accurate, really. I mean, we've all played, like, Silent Hill.
Okay,
that's basically what it is.
Oh, no! Oh, I just walked into that. Oh, yeah. Killing those turkeys, though. No, there's not another big turkey.
There probably is, man.
Why?
It's the level of giant turkeys. Wasn't that a thing in the first Silent Hill? Wasn't one of the alternative endings that...
Giant turkeys?
No. Oh. It was like some demon alien thing.
Yeah, I think so. I never played Silent Hill because I am a pansy?
You know, I've never actually played it, but I own an original copy of it.
Oh, hell yeah, man. That's badass.
I would actually really love to play that on the show sometime.
Well,
it's like, horror games are my jam. And,
Well, dude, horror games are gate. Are great. Gate. They're gate. Ah...
But I love horror games as a game designer because, so like, my philosophy, the reason I love being a game designer is I...
No.
You gotta hunt that turkey butt down.
He was almost dead. I'm getting so much better at killing the big turkeys, I'm not losing all that work I just did.
No, you got this. He ain't getting nowhere. I like horror games as a game designer because, like, I'm all about... getting emotional responses out of players. I think if you do that as a game designer, regardless of whether it's a horror game or not, if you can get an emotional response out of your players, you done good.
Oh, yeah, no, you did really well. No. And whether that's like, that's why I love story-based games that do that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if we ever get a chance, man, I know it's such a popular game, but Telltale's The Walking Dead Season 1 is so incredible. Like, it breaks your heart. it makes you want to play the game over and over again, trying to get new decisions. Wow. Like, dude, it's so good. It doesn't, like, because it's a point-and-click adventure game, story game, mm-hmm. like, the zombie aspect makes it a little more terrifying because there's only so much movement you can do.
Okay, that's fair.
And then things get glitchy. Am I going the right way?
I think you're going the right.
Because I think the turkey was running back to the town. Because right. I think if it gets back to town, it heals up.
Yes, I think you're right.
But I'm actually kind of impressed with myself. I've been managing on not a lot of health.
Yeah, dude, you've been doing great. I think this area is just one big circle. I think you had to kill all the giant turkeys to open, like, a big, big door.
Yeah, I don't know.
What I'm thinking is happening. Yeah,
I kind of wish I knew. I wish this was a little more intuitive.
Wait, turn left. Turn right. That's where you need to go. I'm pretty sure.
I'll find out.
Maybe not. Shit, dude. I don't know.
See, this is where my problem comes in.
Maybe
then.
You do have to go back to Chef now. Maybe this is what this was.
Well, there was one more turkey door, I think, over in that main area.
I think you opened them all.
Well, no, but maybe there's one I didn't go through back in like the main area. Maybe.
Oh yeah, maybe.
So
that was that way, right?
I think.
Oh, there is an arrow.
Oh wait, hold on, there's an arrow here. So.
And there are some turkeys. Okay, no, this is the right way. Oh, this is definitely the right way. But yeah, dude, I would love to actually play the Walking Dead games with you. I know that people really, really have been loving what's the studio called? Telltale. Telltale?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, no, I think it's super cool that they figured out kind of their shtick for their games.
Yes.
Because for a while, like, they didn't make the greatest games. I don't think they were necessarily bad, right?
I think Sam and Max was, like, their big game.
Sam and Max? Oh,
I want to say that they... I don't know if it was, like, Telltale at the time, but I think it was the people from Telltale.
That makes sense. I think I played a couple of other...
I could be totally wrong, though, so if you want to fact-check me and be like, Tony, that are totally right or totally wrong, I'd love to actually know.
Yeah, we'll find it out in post, but,
Oh, God. Oh, man. I'm getting owned by these turkeys. Ah, shit.
But, yeah, like, I'm actually really happy that
they... Oh, that's not what I wanted to do.
I'm really happy they kind of figured out what they wanted to do and, like, started getting a lot of reception for it.
Yeah, right. That's just it. Like, they want to tell games about with good stories. And, like, their most recent game was Game of Thrones.
Mm-hmm.
And, where am I?
Okay. Well, there's a ladder, so that's good. But, yeah, man, like, I guess I was originally put off from... The Walking Dead games because I hate the show with a passion.
Here's the thing. It's not based off of the show. It's actually based off of the comic. And Robert Kirkman has gone on record saying this is the prequel to the comic.
Oh, no way. Dude. The game?
Yes, the game is the prequel to the comic. I want to get over there. Oh,
can
my God.
Can we jump? I don't think we can jump.
I don't
jump.
Think we can jump. And I'm really... sorely regretting no jump button at the moment.
Yeah, really.
Let's see.
That's actually really cool, though. And I didn't know that. Like, I was put off from anything that wasn't the comics for The Walking Dead because I read the comics and I loved
them.
Oh, the
comics are so good. There is nothing better in
right?
this world
like,
than those comics.
I feverishly loved them. Like, oh, they were so good. And they still are good.
Yeah, they make you care about the characters. It's just, they're such a special game.
And like, I've heard that the show gets a lot better. I couldn't make it through the first season.
See, in my opinion, I think the first season's probably their best one. And
really?
Then the second one gets weaker. And the third one, I think their whole curse is that every other season's better. Or something like that.
Interesting. Yeah, I couldn't make it through, I think, the first, like, three or four episodes. And I was just like, you know what? People can like it. No offense. It's just really
I'm
not my,
king
my jam.
King of the world. Oh, God. I don't want to be king of this world. I do not want to be king of this world where there's turkeys. Gobbly, 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 goo.
You know, I gotta wonder, man. Like, the landscape in South Park. Never imagined that it would be this crazy. What the hell is that?
I want to not know.
Oh, it's a boat. I guess. Oh.
Oh, I die. I die. Oh, I die. Am I dying? Am I dying? I don't know how to get out.
I don't think you're dying, actually. What? You're under... What? What?
I don't know what's happening.
Hey, look! Geez.
Oh, this is the area I was in before!
So is that supposed to be, like, a secret area? I guess so. I don't think you can get back up, though. That's interesting, because it rewards you for failing in a way that, like, makes you feel less bad about failing. Oh,
I don't know if this rewarded me for failing! Oh, God. Oh, God. The game is, like, freaking out on me.
Just run, man. Just get out of there.
I can't. There's turkeys everywhere.
I think there's only one left, actually.
Oh, I don't know. I tried so hard and I got so far.
But in the end, it still sort of mattered.
Yeah, I mean, it sort of mattered, yeah. So I'm just kind of wondering.
We gotta go back up.
Yeah, we gotta go back up. Right. But there was that big turkey I didn't finish off.
I think it was up there, wasn't
it? Was it up here? Dude, that's the thing. I don't think it was up here. I thought it was back there, and then we ran, or something happened, and it started running.
Well, we'll find out the hard way.
I mean, yeah. Okay, so this time...
Just book it.
Book it.
Or not. It's so weird. The music changes whenever you fall into the... Oh, nope. I guess we didn't kill him.
Yeah, we didn't kill him.
Does that mean he'll just, reappear over here?
Well, no, because I think he was back in the main area. This is the problem with this game. I think it should give us an objective marker.
Yeah. I mean, maybe that's what they were trying to do with the compass, but...
But the problem is it just points north.
No, it doesn't point north. Well, maybe that's... No, it's not north, because it points at your starting position.
So I think we need to go back to the starting position, right? If it's back near the town, but what the hell? How do I...
I don't think you can get back that way. I don't think there's a way, yeah.
So I wonder if you can get a game over if the turkey,
I don't think so.
Or does it just get its health back? I think it really just gets its health back, but I barely damaged that one, so it wasn't, a big deal.
Oh!
This is not the area we were in before.
No, this is a totally different area. Come on, aim down. All inverted. There we go.
It looks like there's a cheesy poof, so you can get a little more health.
Hell yeah, we're gonna get some cheesy poofs.
Okay, it's my papa.
It's my papa. No kidding, my papa.
This is the terrible Cartman impersonation part.
Okay, it's my papa.
Oh god, I'm. Oh no. Oh jeez.
Oh jeez. Oh no. Oh. I'm gonna roast those turkeys for dinner.
Did turkeys say something?
Maybe they do.
They might.
I mean, they're alien turkeys.
Right? I mean, they got the potential for it. Maybe it was Cartman that said something.
Oh, probably. Cartman kind of sounds like a mutated turkey voice.
I would agree with that.
Bad turkeys.
Man, what would this episode have been like had we been like, all right, we're going to talk like Cartman the entire episode?
It would have been inaudible.
Some ASMR shit right there.
All right.
Inaudible Cartman.
Inaudible Cartman. And it got all like...
Door opened? I opened a door. Oh, maybe...
Sweet mother of God.
Oh, God.
It's turkey time. Gibbly gobbly goobly. Oh, you got more health. There's cheese poofs all over the place. There's another cheese poof right next to you.
You know that screen flash when you pick up an item?
Yeah.
I think that's a Doom thing.
Yeah, it might indeed be.
I know it definitely happened in Doom. I just don't know if they were the first ones. Oh, wow. Oh,
there's more cheese
poofs. There's a lot of stuff over here.
Maybe this is supposed to be like a final boss area.
Oh, shit, dude.
What if we're literally taking...
This is one big thing.
What if we're taking all of the health we're going to need later?
Oh, no. We totally did. Although we still needed it. But fuck, you're right. Shit.
Oh, God.
Do they just infinitely spawn out of here? I'm going to regret that if that is the case. Should have never opened those doors.
Should have never read that book.
They should never read that book.
I'm glad you caught the reference.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, dude. Kickballs.
How many? We should have a lot of those now. I would save almost all those for that final area.
Yeah, dude. Without a doubt.
Yeah, this game would have been just a smidgen bit better if it had,
navigation.
Yep.
I think just even a proper mini map would have been nice. More doors are open.
I don't like the fact that you're opening more doors, Chris.
I know, dude.
The doors you've been opening are dangerous.
Maybe it's just like a quota. You have to kill a certain amount of turkeys.
You're right. But we're doing quite well.
We're doing pretty well, actually.
I don't understand how I did so awful on that first level.
Oh, shit, dude. This is open now. And it didn't have anything but kickballs. Oh, God.
I eat turkeys for breakfast.
That what he said?
I think something like that.
You should pee on a couple of your snowballs. Maybe those will save you.
Nah, because...
That'll take too long.
Yeah. I mean, with these guys, it's a one-shot kill, right? So it's like, you don't need anything more than that.
I wonder if, like, eventually the normal enemies become the giant turkeys, or whether the turkeys get more health as you go on.
I think it's just they have the giant turkeys isn't, like, one of those obstacles.
You can always try and go through.
One thing I do think is really interesting about this game is that every weapon seems to have, like, a normal mode and a power mode.
Yeah, which is kind
of
cool.
That is actually really cool. I don't think that's something that a lot of games even have nowadays. Jeez. Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Kickball. Come on. Oh, God. Oh, it's horrible. Oh. It's because I can't see anything. Oh, God. I got him. Can't see anything.
Dude.
Alright. This will be my reference point. There we go. Okay. And I got more dodgeballs. Lost like 20 health points in doing so. But you know, maybe it was 80 dodgeballs, dude. We are ready to rock some fucking turkeys.
So here's the thing, I think we need to find that big turkey still.
Yes.
So we want to go the other way. Well, really, it's just to follow the main compass, right? Because I think we've decided that the main compass points back home.
Right. I mean, it's like it always points exactly where the starting point is.
Right.
So it's like if there are walls in the way,
it won't won't take that into consideration. Be like,
right.
That's a wall. It's just like really just like overly complicated to get like through things.
Yeah.
But I feel like that was the case with a lot of games.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't know if you ever played Gex.
Oh my God, dude. That's a blast of the past.
I loved Gex. Like Gex 2, I think Gex 3 were the three games.
I don't remember which ones I played. All I know is that I rented them from Blockbuster. I never owned them.
I owned the first and the third.
They were fun, though.
They were a lot of fun, but I think that was another game where after a while... Like, because I think the first one was linear, but then the other ones after that were more open world.
Oh, interesting.
And there's also moments, like, in this game, and it has a very similar soundtrack to this.
Yeah. That's kind of crazy. I wonder if the giant turkey just, like, respawns where it first was encountered.
If we could get our hands on a copy of Gex, one of the Gex games has a snow level where you're fucking up elves.
No way!
Yeah. And they have presents and everything. Like, it's a...
Wow. That would be pretty fun to do on the show. So, we had some other people suggest some holiday-ish games. Like, Dan, actually, one of our music or sound guys / music guy, he suggested that we play a level in Hitman. Blood Money, I believe.
Okay.
Because there's just a silly, like, wintery, Christmassy... level.
Oh.
And someone else suggested that we play Saints Row 4, like, the Christmas DLC. And I was actually all about both of those, but the only reason why we didn't play those, or choose those to play, that's weird, is because we would have to play through most of the game
to get to it.
And I was like, I would love to do it, but either we would use, like, a cheat code to, like, get super far ahead... but then we wouldn't know what we were doing by the time
we got there. Yeah, that's a good point.
That or we would just have to play through it, and it would take a lot of time to get there.
Like, we just probably have to get to that level and then hold off. Like, we wouldn't actually record those levels.
Exactly. And I was like, well, it would be fun, but I don't think it would be worth it for what we're trying to do for the holiday stuff.
So I think that turkey just disappeared. I'm not sure what's going on with that turkey. We'll just keep going ahead.
Yeah. Well, we'll see.
This has been a very long level.
This has been a very long level.
Okay, so we just have to wait for those two to come back and not wait as long as I did. Oh, yeah!
All right, apparently collision is weird enough to
pop us over.
Lots
of turkeys coming up.
Oh, geez.
Don't go too far back either because it'll go into the water.
Yeah, that would be unfortunate. I mean, aside from the largeness and difficulty to navigate, I do kind of like the level design.
Yeah, no, I think it's a lot of fun.
I certainly wouldn't call it great, but I think it's good enough to make this game enjoyable.
Oh, yeah, no, it's definitely enjoyable. And then the fact that it's just South Park characters. Now, I want to know if you can flip between characters, because what is the point of showing?
Dude, you're totally right. Wait, there's got to be a way. Because, yeah, why else would we... Come on, man.
What does B do?
It just changes your weapon.
So A and B both change your weapon?
Yeah, I guess there's just no way to choose the other character.
Hit start. Maybe start has like a character's... no?
No. Yeah, why are they there? Are they just like... Are the pictures just there to be like, hey, the whole gang's here?
Because it makes sense if like if you lost with one character, you played as the next one. Oh, it's your turn to fight a big one.
Oh, yeah. Dude, he's going down. Way down. Wait. It's Pete. Yeah, there we go. Shit.
Ooh, the Pete snowballs do a lot.
Yeah, man. Where it's at. Oh god. Oh, you know, this game is interesting too because it's, they don't really, like, explain anything, really.
No, they just kind of throw you in it. There should be a cheese poof that.
But, like, the game's simple enough to where you don't really need it.
Yeah, not really. I mean, it would have helped to know how to throw the snowballs, I guess. Like, we figured it out. Yeah. And granted, I guess a kid shouldn't be. We were literally right by the finish.
Well, let's do this. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the game's simple enough, right, to where we don't really need to have a tutorial, and that's nice. I've seen so many games nowadays that, like, need tutorials, and they don't have them. And then a lot of games that really don't need tutorials, but they blast it in your face anyway.
Right.
We killed a lot of minions. Oh, my. Needlessly KO'd. Innocent creatures needlessly KO'd.
Yeah, that was in the last round, and you did that twice. You did it twice last round.
Wow, I thought I did it more than twice.
Well, I think maybe you missed a couple of times, and you just kind of walked by them.
Yeah, I see. Oh, jeez.
This is a save the city.
Is this because we...
We let a couple escape?
Maybe.
Because there are two.
Oh, that's totally what it is. That's actually really cool. So it's
it's awesome. I'm glad we actually did that then.
Yeah, here's the consequences of your failure.
I think you should grab a dodgeball for the next one.
That's not a turkey. That's just a sign. Hey, leave that thing alone. I wonder if the city, like, stays destroyed between each of the levels. Because I'm sure this won't be the last of the giant turkeys, right?
Yeah, right. Well, it's spitting out snowballs. Let's butthole instead of turkeys.
Oh.
So it's gonna attack you back.
Weird. Yeah, instead of, like, launching its minions at me. Okay, that one's dead. Is that it? I think we only had two.
And
yeah, okay, there we go.
The town got... That's actually really cool.
Tanks destroyed. Town saved. Yeah, I wonder if new multiplayer characters available.
Bar Brady.
Yay. Nope, because we can't save.
So I'll keep any of this, but...
Oh, and they break it down by episode and stages. Oh, interesting.
So we're still in the first episode, it looks like.
Oh,
what?
Yeah, toilet plunger launcher.
I have a feeling that this episode is just going to turn into, like, us cutting and pasting the best of it for each round.
You can pick up the ammo again. And the love shack is here. Okay, so should we call it here?
I think we should call it here. I think it's cool we saw the plunger gun.
Mm-hmm. So what are your final thoughts about this game?
You know...
I know we didn't make this very game design heavy, but like...
Wait, it's a holiday episode. Yeah. We're playing games that are a little more silly, a little more fun. Maybe the mechanics aren't the best in the world. I'll start with what I liked.
Mm-hmm.
I think the world that they built is a lot of fun. I think they clearly took the show very well.
I think the spirit of the show is
I think the spirit of the show is definitely here.
I think the intelligence of their humor isn't really there.
No, but I don't think there's enough time in this game to do it when it's more of this first-person kind of thing.
Right, exactly.
I'd be interested to see what the other characters do. I think the turkeys are fun enemies, especially when they, like, circle up against you.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're fun, simple enemies. What I wasn't a big fan of is I think... I don't know if crosshairs are a big deal. It might have helped, but whatever.
I think it would have helped. It's not the game where it's like, oh, we don't have the crosshair because it ruins the autistic.
Right, exactly. Like, you're killing turkeys with kickballs right now. that turkey is pooping out babies. Like,
oh, motherfucker.
Oh, it's gonna escape. It's gonna escape. And I also don't like the way the map works.
Yeah, I definitely agree.
I think the map's a little goofy. I think the weapons are great, though. That might be the highlight of this game, how the weapons work.
Yeah, yeah, actually, I completely agree. I mean, paired with the humor, right?
Right, like, paired with the humor. Does the toilet plunger just act like the snowball where it just hits it and does damage, or...?
It shoots a lot straighter.
Oh, look at that. That's actually really cool. And then you can re-pick
maybe,
it up.
Yeah, maybe I'll just keep using this because you can, just pick up your ammo again.
But that's what I loved so about it. I think this is a fun game, and I would definitely like to continue playing at some point.
Did you ever play the newer South Park game?
No, RPG? Stick of Truth?
I wonder, like... I know that game is very well received.
I've heard that like it's one of those games that you want to keep playing over and over and over again, and so good on them for doing that. I don't think it's the same company.
No, it's definitely not the same studio. I wonder though, like I'm curious if this game, if like the production of this game paid off for the developers and
I wonder. Hopefully it did.
Yeah.
I think it's a really fun game, and I think it's one of those games where, again, you could have a game night and play, like, the arena fights, which I'm sure are a blast.
Mm-hmm. I guess, what's our question of the day? Do you want to ask about, kind of the level design and the mini-map system?
You know, I feel like for this one, since we're doing a holiday, since this was more of a goofy episode, I kind of want to ask if you could pick a random holiday to create a whole video game about.
What would you want to create? Yeah. Yeah, because, I mean, there's so many games that are, like, Christmas.
Yeah.
Or like, even, like, I don't know, Halloween, right?
Right. But, like, if you could just pick a random non-popular holiday, like, what would it be? And what would your enemy be? Because I think that's the most fun. Like, having this, like, kind of pseudo-Thanksgiving Christmas turkey aliens. Oh, dude, the plunger does...
I just wrecked him.
Holy crap.
Wow.
But I think that's a pretty okay question.
Yeah, I like that question. Cool. Well, thank you everyone for watching.
This we'll see you guys
a ridiculous
later.
Playthrough.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun. Like, comment, subscribe. Let us know what you think about our playthrough of this.
Yeah. And we'll see you in the comments.
Hey, goodbye.
Bye, everybody.
You really had to make me look that bad, huh? You're just like, I'm going to get like almost 5,000 points. What did Tony get? 400? Yeah.
You just gotta not die.
Oh, thanks, coach. Thanks.